I put it on. on, do that one more time.
I love you, Jesus. Keep it unison.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
That I love you more.
Lord, I love you.
More.
More than anything.
I guess we'll stay apart.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
That I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More.
More than anything.
I love Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
That I love you more.
More than anything. I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you
that I love you more.
Lord, I love you.
Now, if you really love him, lift your hands and worship him for a second. Come on, just talk to him. I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you
that I love you more. More.
I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore.
Just want to tell you that I love you more. Now this time around, if you really love him, I want you to lift your hands and talk to him. Come on, we're not gonna sing it. I just want you to speak well of him. Come on, talk to the Lord. God, we honor you. God, we magnify you. We lift your name on high.
Yeah, God, we honor you.
We love you for who you are.
And we magnify your name. Lord, I love you more than anything. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love.
Anybody know he loved you that much?
That's love.
Come on, can we sing that one time to the Lord?
Jesus went to Calvary.
To save a wretch. Like you and me.
He's the lover of my soul.
Come on, do it again.
Jesus went to Calvary.
Sing Jesus went. Let's bring that thing full circle.
Jesus went to Calvary, yeah. To Calvary.
Friends of Calvary. They hung him high, stretched him wide. Put your hands together for Jesus.
Hallelujah. Come on, if you got a reason to give the Lord some praise, come on, put those hands together. Come on, if you know he went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me, if you're thankful for it and you're grateful for it, come on, show him with your hands. Come on, show him with those hands. Praise the Lord in this place. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. The Lord is certainly worthy of the glory, honor, and the praise. Has God been good to anybody in here this week? Look at somebody real fast and tell them God's been good to me. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. It's just a blessing, as we always say, to be in the service of the Lord once more and again. To all of our preachers who are present, to each of our deacons and to our mothers, to each of you, God's people, we always say it's a blessing to be in the service of the Lord. Once more and again, one more time. Grateful for those of us who are visiting with us today. Come on, Greater Faith, let's give it up for all of our visitors, those who are here, those who are watching. We are praying that God would continue to find favor in you and keep blessing you real good. Tonight is the kickoff of our Gospel Explosion 2K15. Gospel Explosion 2015, praises be to the Lord. This revival has been blessing this church, this community, and this city for 20 years consecutively. Praise the Lord. That's something to celebrate about. Amen. You are welcome to come back, and I want to see all of us present tonight. Kicking us off this year will be none other than Pastor Charles Jenkins and the Fellowship Church of Chicago. Amen. You know him. Amen. This means war, and my God is awesome. They will be here tonight, and the choir will be ministering, and we're going to have a wonderful time in the Lord. I want to see you. Make sure you're here. Amen. In the flesh, in the presence. Make sure you're here with us. Amen. Tonight, as we kick off at 7 o'clock. sharp. Tuesday night, we'll have Pastor Cedric Veal. Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. Wednesday, we'll have Bishop R.J. Burt. Amen. We'll be here Wednesday night. Thursday, Pastor Cliff Mays of Toledo, Ohio will be here on this Thursday night. And Friday, none other than the personality of the Dr. Donald L. Parson will be here to close this 20-year celebration out. We're going to have a wonderful time in the Lord, and we're praying that we see each and every one of you throughout this week. But make sure you're with us here, amen, tonight at 7 o'clock. As a matter of fact, we're going to wear all of our T-shirts, everybody tonight. You got your Greater Faith T-shirt. If you didn't get the new T-shirt, we'll make sure you try to get it today from Sister Bobby. If not, whatever Greater Faith T-shirt you have, I want you to wear it here tonight. Amen? Wear it. That's just how much hot it's going to be. It's going to be smoking in this place. Make sure. I want you to be comfortable. Amen. Wear your T-shirt. Amen. Your Greater Faith T-shirt. Whichever one, just represent Greater Faith tonight. Whichever T-shirt you have. Make sure you have your Greater Faith T-shirt on tonight. Praise the Lord. We don't want to hold you long. There is a word from the Lord. We want to invite your attention. We're going to divert from our series that we began. The Lord has kind of led us to take another route today. Amen. Meet us. Gospel according to Matthew chapter 9. Amen. Gospel of Matthew chapter 9. Say amen. Praise the name of the Lord. It says here, for she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be whole. For she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be whole. For she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, somebody said garment, I shall be whole. I want to talk about encourage yourself to survive. Encourage yourself to survive. Look at the person by you real quick. Tell them, say, neighbor, encourage yourself to survive. Come on, look at the other person. Tell them, neighbor. Tell them, encourage yourself to survive. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand of praise here. Thing about our text that caused us to reiterate and revisit a passage of scripture that is no stranger to many of us. We have visited by Sister Veronica quite a few times. But as we were in prayer with the Lord this morning and going back and reflecting and recollecting over many of the events that have been taking place in the news media, many events in the lives of members that I reflected upon, text messages and emails and phone calls. And just being connected with people that caused me to reflect this morning, as God put upon my spirit to have another conversation with us about this woman of chapter 9 who had a particular circumstance that plagued her for 12 years. Thought that it was befitting to look at this because whether you are those or that one who's going through a situation or circumstance, or whether you have already been there and lived through it, we need to come to a resolution to make a solution, that we need to become more sound within our own mind. Spiritual maturity, that we trust God enough to not wait for Him to take us out, bring us through, bring us out, take us over, take us under, deliver us in manifestation, but we need to have enough strength within ourselves, in our knowing Him and trusting Him, that because of Him, we can encourage ourselves. And not only just, church, encourage ourselves, but to seemingly encourage ourselves to survive. Because whether we realize it or not, if you just take a toll to look all around us, if there was ever a time that we needed to gain strength in our personal encouragement, church, the time is now. Not only are we as Christians being attacked by the wiles of the devil, even within our own personal lives and our own personal circumstances, of being dehumanated and degraded, or being disappointed by situations and outcomes not really being the way in which we either expect or either the way in which we look for them to be or become. It's not only just that, but we have it in the world where it seems as if, you know, being a child of God is something unheard of. It's something difficult. We're even now in a time where it seems as if even talking about the Bible or the things within the Bible are unconstitutional. Now, I don't know whatever since the Bible has become degraded to be a constitutional issue, because the Word of God was here even before the Constitution was founded. And sisters and brothers, don't let nobody fool you. The Constitution of the United States was founded upon the truths that are within the Word of God from Genesis to Revelation. I don't care who you are, the justice system, who it is a representation of the United States Constitution. You atheist, you agnostic, you unbeliever, you untruster, you who are suggestively in question about having a relationship with God, of the truths of the Bible to be real, you cannot stand in a court of law and be on a witness stand with your unatheist
atheistic, your agnostic, your unbelieving self. You can't even speak in the court of law except you take your left hand and put it on the truth, the word of God, and your right hand and say, I solemnly swear. I wish I had a witness here. But we need to be able now to encourage ourselves to survive, not wait on the opinions or waiting upon the assurance of others. Sometimes you have to be able to encourage yourself. As a matter of fact, let me stick a pin right there. When you know the Lord, you ought to be able to encourage yourself anyway. When you are a child of God, church, listen, you ought to be able to encourage yourself when you know who the Lord is. Can I tell you real quick who the Lord is? This is why I said you ought to be able to encourage yourself, because when you are kin to God, when you become a child of God, as a matter of fact, the Bible says it like this: let the redeemed of the Lord say so. The redeemed of the Lord means kinship. It means kin to. It means connected to. So when you are the redeemed, or when you are a child of God, you are automatically connected to God. What you mean, preacher? Well, his spiritual DNA is inside of who you are. When you accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, come on, his blood covers you. And when his blood covers you, what's in his spiritual DNA is now covering you, and it is a part of you. So why you say, Reverend, you need to be able to encourage yourself when you connected to God? I'm glad you asked that question. It's real simple. It can't even be oversimplified. The main reason why you can encourage yourself, church, you got to know him. And when you know him, you know he's sovereign. And see, listen, I done shouted myself. When you know he's sovereign, you know what sovereign means? Sovereign means self-existing. It means he's God, and he's God all by himself. He doesn't need no help. He doesn't need anybody else. Now, his sovereignty is the existence of him being sovereign. That means he rules, and he super rules where he rules. So if you know that God is in control, you need to be able to encourage yourself. Yeah, I'm broke, but God's gonna fix it. I know I don't have a job right now, but God is still in the blessing business. I know I need a way made out of no way, but God is in control. Is there anybody in here that know he's in control? Give your neighbor a high five and tell him, when God is in control, you don't need nothing else. So this is why I said you got to be able to encourage yourself to survive. This woman of our text, I already took too many minutes. When you look at the text, the woman we know, we're familiar with the woman of this text. She was sick with the issue of blood for 12 years. Long time. 12 years for something that, Let me explain her situation. She really had a condition that she couldn't do nothing with. She had this condition for 12 years. But I was always fascinated at how she was healed. Dick Thompson, I always rushed. I always preached this because of the fact of the matter. I was intrigued about how trusting and how believing she was in the power of the Lord that she could even be healed even by bypassing conversation. Because the Bible says he didn't touch her, she touched him. She didn't touch his hand, church, she touched his clothes. She didn't touch his collar, she touched the hem of his sheath. But can I tell y'all what really made me shout this morning? It really wasn't in the miracle. It was how she was operating in the meantime. What really made me shout wasn't in her being healed, but it was how she was able to operate on her way to her miracle. Let me show you what I'm talking about. First reason why I say that you have to be able to encourage yourself to survive, because this woman, first of all, was operating with the disease. It's in your Bible, verse number 20. She was operating with the disease. The Bible says, and behold, a woman which was diseased with an issue of blood 12 years came behind him and touched the hem of his garment. She was diseased with an issue of blood 12 years. Now, when you look at the description of her disease, church, she had a situation going on. Let me explain what was happening, because maybe y'all forgot the saga. Let me tell you what happened. She had an issue of blood. Okay. Now, she was in a daily recurring cycle that should have only been 12 times a year, once a month. You'll catch it. This for grown folk right now. So she had something that was supposed to start and stop but keep reoccurring. But church, it never stopped. It just kept going 12 years straight, not stopping. 12 years. My mama told me a long time ago that the body has a certain amount of pints of blood that in the decreasing of blood flow, it even needs a certain amount to rejuvenate. And if you don't have that particular certain amount to re-metastasize, you need to get blood from somewhere else. This woman never had a blood transfusion, but kept bleeding 12 years straight. Okay, y'all just don't know when to shout. The miracle really wasn't in her getting the healing, but the miracle was in her being preserved. Okay, what I'm really saying is, church, she should not have survived, but she was still alive with her disease. Y'all still don't get it. She should have been dead, but she was still operating with her disease. Is there anybody in here that's got that same kind of testimony? You had some kind of situation that, as a matter of fact, you should have been dead. You could have been dead. As you check the record, it was other folks who were where you were doing the same thing. And they're either dead now, in jail, or have lost their mind. But blessed be the name of the Lord. He didn't see fit for none of those things to be with me, because every day by his power, he was keeping me when I couldn't keep myself. Is there anybody in here that can shout on the fact that you don't know why you are still alive, but you thank God he preserved you?
Look at somebody and tell them, I'm preserved. Y'all want to act bougie. I promise you, if the person next to you knew who you really used to be and knew what you really used to do, the person beside you might even change their seat. But blessed be the name of the Lord. Even when I shouldn't have been preserved, he still kept me. Look at somebody and testify, I know he kept me. I know.
Preserved. She was, should have been dead, but she was alive. Church, watch the text. Look at the description now. She was kept alive, but the Bible says that she had an issue of blood. But see, the issue of blood was not her disease. She became diseased with her issue. Okay,
let me show you.
Look, read your Bible, read just like this. A woman, behold a woman, verse 20, which was diseased with an issue of blood. She had an issue of blood, but the issue of blood was not her disease. She became diseased with the issue of blood. Okay. If this was her disease, church, it would have been present tense. Matter of fact, it would have been present tense indicative. If this was her disease, that means that it was continuously ongoing. But see, when you look at the word diseased, it's not in a noun form, it's a verb. And it's a verb that's in the text that's dedicated to past tense. Okay. So basically, she's now carrying something that she's diseased with. Okay, let me say, I don't want to lose you. The word disease in this text means to become. To become. Not to be, but to become. See, church, to be is like the man who was born blind. It wasn't nothing he could do about that because the Bible says he was born blind from birth. Come on, y'all. Come on, don't lose me now. But she was not born like this from birth. Come on, y'all. She ain't wake up like this. She wasn't born like this from birth, but she became diseased with an issue of blood. Are y'all seeing? Okay, the issue of blood, her reoccurring flow, was her issue. It was not a disease. But over time, she became diseased with her issue. Okay. Can I say it one more time? She was not born with the issue. She contracted this issue. And I don't know, maybe because it kept reoccurring, she became diseased with issue of blood. Okay. Her issue was blood. Reoccurring over and over again, one day after the other. Keep on looking at it. Keep on seeing it. Keep on feeling it. Keep on being a part of it. Keep on being around it. Can't get away from it. Can't walk away from it.
Can't run away from it. Can't sleep away from it. Can't drink away from it. Come on, y'all, talk to me, somebody. It became a part of her. She became diseased. What is your issue? Okay. What is your problem? What is your circumstances? We all got some kind of issues. And sometimes you got to be careful of talking about other people's issues who have been exposed. Because a lot of times we all have some issues, but our public is still private. Let me say that again. Your private has not become public, so you got to be careful about talking about other folks who issues you know about, because we all have some kind of issue. But here's the thing, church. Don't let your issue become your disease. Y'all don't want to talk back to me. When? Y'all don't know when to shout. I said, don't let your issue become your disease. Don't let what you're going through become a part of you that it starts to affect you for who you are. Don't let your life become your label. Bartimaeus had a name, but he was known as blind Bartimaeus because his issue became his disease. Y'all don't want to, y'all ain't saying nothing. Don't let your, what you're going through become your disease. Don't let what you're going through make you get tired of living. Don't let what you're going through get you to the place where you give up hope and you give up trust and you give up faith. Y'all ain't got to say nothing, but I know some people in the building, you've had some situations that you couldn't really get yourself out of, and instead of saying I come this far by faith, you was trying to figure out how you was gonna make it on your own. But the devil is a liar. Just because you're going through, it don't have to be a part of you. Look at your neighbor real quick and tell him, say, neighbor, trouble is only temporary. Situations are only seasonal. I don't know how long you're going to be there. She was there 12. But when the Lord is ready to move, if you got the faith, he'll move you. Look at your neighbor real fast and tell him, say, neighbor, he's done too much for you to give up on him now. You ain't the only one. Pick your head up, sir. Pick your faith up. You ain't the only one going through something. I know this might be your first one, but you ain't the only person that's lost a job. Come on. You ain't the only person that's been diagnosed with a sickness. When you are a child of God, your issues should never change your identity. If I'm going to praise him when I'm up, I'm going to glorify him. When I'm down, I'll bless him at all. At all times. I didn't spend too much time. She was operating with her disease. Not only was she operating with her disease, church, but she was operating with determination. Look at your neighbor, tell him she was determined. She was determined. Come on, y'all, right there in verse number 21. For she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be whole. She said to herself, if I touch his garment, I'll be whole. Church, as she was proceeding to where Jesus was, there was a press, a crowd.
Jesus on his way to Jairus' house. And I'm sure she got tired trying to get closer to him. But she said within herself, if I may but touch the hem of his garment, I'll be made whole. Church, that's determination. Can I just give you just a little background? Give me 2 minutes. I won't take long. Watch this. She was now at a place where she was alone, nobody to count on. She was sick, and she was broke. I mean, I wish I had time. DeMarc tells us that she spent all her money going from doctor to doctor. She didn't just go to one doctor. She went from doctor to doctor to doctor to doctor to doctor. Prior to about 13th or 14th opinion, she spent all her money. Only reason why she spent her money, because every doctor she went to told her they could do it. But she had failure after failure, disappointment after disappointment. And church, Jesus ain't no doctor. Let me rephrase that, because somebody gonna take this soundbite and try to say I'm preaching an unethical gospel. No, see, Jesus is not a doctor in the realm of how she's comfortable knowing. Ain't no MD on his name, but MD is in his power. So now she had to look beyond Father than what she was used to seeing. She ain't never seen him operate in an operating room, but she was determined enough to say to herself that yes, they fail me, but if I get closer to Jesus, he'll change everything about me. Is there anybody in here that know Jesus is powerful enough to do the unexplainable, to do what no other can do? Look at your neighbor real quick and tell him, say, neighbor, you can be determined to walk with Jesus, because with him no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. Church, I got to get out of here. She was determined. She said within herself. And see, church, you ain't got to talk to nobody. Sometimes if you know what to say to yourself, you can benefit yourself. Don't let nobody fool you. Now, it's not good, you know, to answer yourself. Because if you talk to yourself and yourself start answering yourself now, probably didn't eat something too good, but you. It's all right to be able to talk. The Lord told Joshua to talk to himself. Come on, y'all Bible readers, Joshua chapter 1. He says, meditate, Joshua, meditate on this book of the law day and night. That simply means, Joshua, you got to speak low and speak consistently to yourself the word of God. And I promise you, my sister, I promise you, my brother, if you start speaking the word over your life, things will start happening. Healing will start taking place. Joy will start increasing. You got to speak the word over yourself. Look at your neighbor and tell them, speak a word over yourself. Speak it. Not only was she operating with determination, church, she was operating distinctively. Because see, she didn't go to just anybody any kind of way. She went to Jesus distinctively. Okay, it's in your Bible. Watch what happened. She touched his garment, verse 22. Jesus, matter of fact, looked around and said, somebody touch me. They said, Master, Oh, a lot of people done touched you. We can't figure out who done touched you. He said, no. Somebody touched me and caused virtue to leave from me. Somebody connected to me and accessed my power. So I'm looking for that one who knew how to get something from me they never had. Oh, okay. Okay. All right. All right. Okay, church, watch this. Watch this. I promise you I'm going. I said I was going to be 25 minutes. We're gone. We're done. Watch the text. This is a good place. I ain't done preaching. This is a good place to stop, though. This is what happened. Watch what happened. She didn't go to Jesus to have a conversation. She went to Jesus to get her conclusion. Because she distinctively went to Jesus to be made whole. Now, I'm like Jesus too in a sense, because this miracle was different. You know, normally Jesus conversed with folks, you know, and challenged them, you know, and said, do you believe I could do this? She, come on, y'all. Man was blind. He spit on him and put dirt on his face. He said, now, if you want to see, go wash. Go. Said the man by the pool of Bethesda, by the pool of Siloam, by the pool of Bethesda, for that was there for about 38 years, couldn't get up, get to the pool for, to get healed after the angel got out the pool once a year. Church, don't y'all remember what Jesus said? He said, if you want to get well, why don't you get up? He challenged folks, converse with them. This woman didn't talk to Jesus. But she went to him knowing she could get healed. Now watch this, church. She didn't go to Jesus to release his productivity. She didn't go to Jesus because he was a miracle worker. She didn't go to Jesus to be astonished. She didn't go to him for him to release productivity, for him to show her how to get well. Church, she went to Jesus for him to release his power. Y'all don't know when to shout. She didn't go to talk to him. She went to him because she knew that the closer she got to him, she would get the results that she needed to be changed. All I'm trying to tell you, church, is that a lot of times you ain't got to talk to the Lord about your issues. But if you go to him to access his power, go to him to get changed, the Lord's power will change your situation. Is there anybody in here that's ever can be honest with yourself and everybody around you that the closer you got to the Lord, the more about you started to change? Your walk was different. Your talk was different. Look at your neighbor and tell him, say, neighbor, to get something from him you never had, you gotta do something you never done. Stop asking and start seeking. Stop requesting and start drawing closer to him. You draw nigh unto the Lord. Feel pretty good now. You draw nigh unto the Lord. Church, I promise you, the Lord, yeah, will draw nigher unto thee. This woman of the text, yes, had an issue of blood, but she came to the master to change her situation. But church, not only did she come to the Lord to change her situation, but she came to the Lord encouraging herself. Did you hear me? She shows us that
When you encourage yourself, the Lord will preserve you to survive. Yeah, when you encourage yourself, the Lord will work miracles on your way to being changed. Yeah, the record is that naturally this woman should have died. Yeah, this woman should not have lived through her circumstances. Yes, my Lord. But I want to tell somebody that she was preserved even in her situation. Yes, my Lord. And I come to remind somebody that I don't care how bad it is. I don't care how difficult it seems. I don't give a care if you are tired of being sick and tired. I want you to realize that the Lord is still keeping you. The Lord is still providing for you. I said the Lord still has his arms around you. Can I get a witness that don't mind testifying to somebody around you? Look at a neighbor and tell them, say, neighbor, you might be broke, but you're not broken. You might be sick, but you're not dead. You might be down, but you're not out, because God is still keeping you. You can encourage yourself in the Lord. Sometimes speak a word over your life and you will be healed. Speak a word over yourself and the word of God will dry up your tears. If you speak a word over yourself, you'll be able to encourage yourself to the end. Look at a neighbor and grab them by the hand. Oh! Yes, sir. Good God. Oh! Oh! Yes, sir. Grab them by the hand and say, neighbor, encourage yourself to survive. Shake their hand and say, neighbor, whatever your issues are, or whatever it is, tell them, encourage yourself in the Lord. Says sometimes, neighbor, you have to encourage yourself. Sometimes speak victory in the midst of your tests, because God is on your side. Yeah! Won't he take care of you? I know you can encourage yourself. Can I tell you why? Simply because when you have God on your side, he is more than the world against you. Can I get a witness? You can encourage yourself in the Lord, because God is too big to be small. Come is to omnipresent, to be absent. God is to omniscient, to be powerless. I said, come is to omniscient, to be dumb. He's to omnipotent, to be powerless. Yes, my Lord. I said, God is too sovereign to be weak. I said, God is too powerful not to be a healer. He's too powerful not to be a way maker. Can I get a witness that no, you can encourage yourself in the Lord? Cry up a neighbor, pat a hand, tell him, said neighbor, encourage yourself, because God, I said, God has got your back. I'm trying to quit, but I done got a happy. I'm a witness that you can encourage yourself. I'm a witness that you can survive. Can I tell you how? That whenever I'm sick, he medicates. When I'm down, he deliberates. When I'm enemies all around me, he emancipates. And whenever I'm weak, he deliberates. Is there anybody here that know God will take care of you? Is there anybody here that know the Lord will see you through? Grab a neighbor by the hand one more time and said, neighbor, I'm not playing with you. I know you're getting tired of me shaking your hand, but say one more time, I want to encourage you that the Lord will take care of you. Be not dismayed, whatever be tried, God will. Oh, he will. Yeah. 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 Ah. Won't he take care of you? Won't he take care of you? Won't he take care of you? If you know he will take care of you, ease your arm around somebody. Ease your arm around somebody and tell them, said neighbor, I don't know what you're going through, but tell them, with God all things are possible. Said neighbor, you're next in line for a miracle. Yeah! Ah, yeah! Yeah! Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? I'm trying to quit, but I done got happy. Some on the inside done got a hold of me. I wish I had a witness here that no, God is able to help you to survive. put your hand in a neighbor's hand. Come on and shake their hand. Shake their hand and rock their hand. Shake their hand and rock their hand. Shake them and rock them. Rock them and shake them. Shake them and rock them. Rock them and shake them. Said, neighbor, I'm trying to encourage you on what it feels like to hold the hand of somebody that should have been dead, but I'm a survivor. I'm a survivor. Let everything that's a survivor, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Yes! Look at a neighbor and say, I'm still here. Oh, I'm still here. Oh, I'm still here. Oh, I'm still here. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm a survivor. Oh, 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 I'm a survivor. Yeah. Woo. Survivor. Oh, shucks. If you know you're a survivor, you ought to be giving them praise. Give two people a high five and tell them, survive, survive. Still here. It's by the grace of God. Oh, oh, I am still here. It's by the grace of God.
No.
I am still here. It's by the grace of God. Anybody here got the testimony? Look back over your life and say, I am still here. It's by the grace of God. Oh, I am still here. It's by the grace of God. The doors are open. The doors are open. We extend an invitation. There may be somebody present here today. God.